Today I want to talk to you about my kit. Hello, fashion. These are things that I take with me whenever I go to work on a red carpet or to a shoot. And this one's been with me a while. It's full of a lot of stuff. I don't know that I need it all because I can edit it to what I actually use and show that to you now. So I got a new one. It's smaller and cleaner. And this one's kind of been all over the world. When I'm sending a client off on a press tour on her own, I usually give her a smaller one, one more like this. And I'll tailor it just to her. Everybody has different needs and outfits have different needs. So if I know what outfits I'm working with, I know what they're gonna need. Okay, look at how fresh it is. This one has seen better days. This side is the hardware side. For instance, this is a sweater stone. This is super essential. The laundress makes this one and I really like it. It's lightweight, so it's easy to pack. And it just takes any pilling off a knit. I'm dealing with samples a lot of the time, so they've been worn and they've also been packed. So sometimes they just get little stuff on them. This is one of my favorite tools. This is a leather hole punch and you can use it to put extra holes in belts and in shoe straps. Often people like to wear their shoe straps a little tighter than normal so that they feel secure, especially if they have to walk across the stage. So this has multiple different sizes and I can put holes in leather really easily with this. Other hardware that I always have is a box of safety pins. Matte black safety pins are super useful because you can use them on a lot of clothes and you don't see them. I have a dressmaker's measuring tape always. I always have a sewing kit with needle and thread and extra buttons and a seam ripper, which is a little tool where you can just open a seam that may be too tight. Maybe an alteration was done. If I'm sewing, it's not a good day. I have basic sewing skills, but I really rely on my tailors. I always have one of these because sometimes there's a button, there's something. I did one time sew a Golden Globes dress onto a client before she walked out the door. It's a real low point in my career, honestly. Okay, the other thing I always have is these clips. These are from the hardware store and they have silicone tips on them. They come in all different sizes. They come in different colors. These are more for photo shoots. I would never send these on a red carpet, but for instance, on a press junket or for a picture, you can easily cinch the back of a garment with these without putting holes in it. In Lost in Translation, Bill Murray walks off the photo shoot and he has them running down the whole back.
Is it mainly Buddhism here or is it?
Yeah, the Buddhism.
City or something.
Yeah, it's not a city.
There are some quirky vibey things in here that are very important to me. I always have a speaker because I find music can always change a tone and set a good tone. Some people like it turned off, that's fine, but I have it in case. Another thing I always have is aura smudge. It's spray sage. Again, if the vibe is off, I can clean it up. Makes people feel relaxed, it smells good. One thing that I ask clients to do that is painful is wear high heels a lot. People like to wear high heels because they're flattering. They make clothes look good, they make you feel confident, but they can hurt. So I have a lot of things in here to make heels hurt less. I have ball of foot pads. I have full gel inserts. One of my favorite tricks for foot pain is CBD lotion. I buy this at the dispensary in California, and I have found that using CBD lotion on people's feet makes it possible for them to wear higher heels for longer. These are gloves. When I'm dealing with a gown that is very easily stained, I like to wear white cotton gloves because everybody's got hairspray, makeup, whatever snack they ate last on their hands. And sometimes you need to really hold a dress in order to zip it up and get it closed. And I find that wearing gloves prevents stains. So another thing that I keep on this side of my kit is solutions for dresses. This is static solution from the laundress. And I pack this travel size one in almost every kit because static can be a real problem, especially in hotel rooms because of the carpet. And I prefer the way this one smells to traditional static guard. This is a brush I took from a hotel room closet in Europe. I love these brushes. This is a really easy way to get lint off coats and jackets and heavier suiting fabric, and it brushes the nap down on the actual weave of the fabric and makes it look really sharp. This is top stick. It is double-sided tape. It was originally for men's toupees. It doesn't hurt your skin.
Part it on the right. It stays better in the wind.
I try to use excellent tailoring as much as possible, but I would also never go anywhere without this. Shout wipes are something I put in people's bags always if they're wearing white, and something I always have. This is a bizarrely useful tool, which is a ring sizer. You would be shocked by the fact that nobody knows their ring size. Okay, then in here, just in case of emergency, I have like a beauty package, which is deodorant, which is often something people request last minute. A toothbrush, same. Tampons, last minute. And then lots of medicine. I have Claritin, Alka-Seltzer, Advil. Okay, what's over here is starting to get into the soft goods. This is a new bra, which is a stick-on bra, which is fantastic if you're a small C or below. This is a bra you can just stick on and clip in the middle. And so it's great for backless or very, very low-cut dresses, things with open sides. And it covers the nipples and also provides a little bit of lift and a little bit of togetherness. There are two different nipple covers that I like, and it depends what they're going underneath. Silicone nipple covers are beautiful and smooth and really easy to take on and off, but sometimes you can see the edge of them. If they're going under a silk dress, you can see a circle where the nipple would be. So they're not always usable, in which case I use these petals, which are more like a Band-Aid, and they disappear, but they're a little less pleasant to use. Another thing I use, which is hilarious, is the Bring It Up, which is a sticker. Again, this is for smaller boobs, but this is a sticker where you can basically lift the boob up without a bra. So it's great for a slip dress, a backless dress, a dress with no sides, that kind of thing, just to pick things up. I find it much easier to use than the duct tape style. So this is the soft side of the kit, and this kit is all underwear. For award season, I take a kit like this because it kind of has something for everyone. It has all my favorites in it. If I were packing a smaller kit for a specific client, I wouldn't need all this because I know their bodies and I know what they're wearing. The most essential thing that I always have a few of, usually one for every day, are these commando thongs. I love that they come in little boxes because people know they're clean. They're easy to spot because they're bright pink, and they are the most invisible thong that's comfortable that I know of. They come in all different skin tones. They're seamless, so they always go in. Skims solution wear bodysuits, and these are really full coverage. These go up to your shoulders and down to your knee. I love that they're really comfortable, but they provide compression and nice shaping. And the reason I use these is because clothes lay really beautifully over top of them. I don't think people need to wear this kind of thing every day. Some people find the compression comfortable. I find it terribly uncomfortable, but when I want my clothes to look really good or for a special occasion, I always use these. They make you feel you have good posture, you stand up straight, your body is all held in.
By the stretching of certain muscles and contracting of certain muscles, your posture can be made perfect.
There's something comforting about them, and the seams lay straight down the side of your hip instead of getting caught, you know, here or there on your body. So those are great. This is my good luck robe. I bought this in a thrift store on a shoot on location because I needed a robe, but I almost always have it in my kit because people need to wear something while they have their hair and makeup done that they can take off without messing up their hair and makeup. I love that this is a cute little color. It's really easy to wash, and it rolls up very small. So I have that always, just in case there isn't a terry robe in the hotel or the studio where we're getting ready. Let's see, these are some more specific concern items. This is a corset from Cosabella that we buy by the case. This little corset bra is one of my very favorite things to use when I need a strapless bra. And the reason is it's very strong, and the fact that it has a longer line means that it holds up better. It also has a bone on the side, and I find that if you can push in the side a little bit, you get a narrower silhouette. I often use these when we're making custom dresses as the base. If I give the designer this bra in the correct size, they can drape the dress around it, and I'll know that my client will feel supported and that there'll be a strong structure underneath the dress. This is Spanx, and this panty is something I use very often. It's a thong, and it's seamless in the way that the commando is, but it has control panels all throughout. So this is great if you're postpartum. It's great if you're just feeling a little bloated. It's great if you just need a little reminder to hold your tummy in. What I like most about this one is it has a really good touch. It feels luxurious, and it's not quite as ugly as some of them are. So one of the things that I do that's a little unconventional is padding bodies. This is a pair of panties that has butt pads in it. I learned this from a costume designer, that sometimes the way to make areas of the body look smaller is to make other areas look bigger. A cute little padded butt is great if you don't have one. I often, in an evening gown, especially in a strapless gown, remove the pads from the underwear and then sew them into the dress or tuck them into something like the Skims, because if you pad the hip, the waist looks smaller. I think everybody remembers that they used to tell people to wear shoulder pads to make your waist look smaller, and this is the same thing. Often, actresses are so thin and tiny, and when you put a column dress on a thin, thin, tiny, fit little woman, she can look like a tube sometimes, where if you just give her a little bit of a hip, she gets like a much curvier, cuter silhouette. This is a La Perla bodysuit, which is so beautiful that I often carry it around just because it makes me happy. It's totally transparent and gorgeous. It's actually really functional and looks like skin. And a lot of people like to have an unlined cup, and this is a way of giving support and control without all the pressure and the padding. I always have a pair of men's trouser socks. We seem to forget about socks a lot, all of us. When you have a boot with a look, suddenly you realize you need a sock. I almost always have a white and a black Wolford bodysuit. These are my favorite layering pieces. They're very fancy and they look great. They're soft, they're matte, they're comfortable. And when I want the look of a t-shirt under a jacket or under a dress, I often use a bodysuit because then you don't have to worry about it coming untucked or buckling in the front. It's really smooth. The fabric is really dense and matte, so you don't get that shine across the front. You don't see the bra through. Wolford bodysuits are something I almost always have. Okay, this is a waist cincher. Some people let me put these on, some people don't. They are really intense.
Squeeze my waist into the size of an orange and a half when I was Prudence's age. Your sister shall do the same.
Is she to breathe, Mama?
You put it on and you can hook it up the back and put it inside and zip it up. This can make your waist, like, I would say almost 2 centimeters smaller. All right, let's pack it up. So that's my kit. I like a white suitcase. You can spot them first on the baggage claim. Don't forget to subscribe, like, follow, ring the bell. See you next week.